Because I'm your favorite random man, Future King of YouTube. Terrence was in the building today, and how you guys doing? Those you already know, Youmacon was like a week or two ago, and I had to say this by far was the best Youmacon that I've ever been to or attended. I was completely excited to do this one. Okay, I don't know what scared the crap out of me though, but I think that's the air to my air mattress. But anyways, guys, as you can see, I'm dressed in my Captain America attire for my time at Youmacon. I only wanted to do two this year, but man, the game room for the Youmacon. I'm going a little bit overboard here, but I have to say, there was a little complications, which I will go into. And towards the end of the video, I'm gonna just showcase some of the pictures I took, and the people who I met, and some really good personal stories here. But guys, I can say, like, going back to Youmacon, the game room was a whole lot better. I don't remember if I did a reaction to Youmacon for last year when I did my reaction to video. I don't think I did or not. But the game room was awful. It was bad. Short. Half of the games I wanted to play not in there. But it definitely got all the new games, the classic games in there. That's always what Youmacon does. I saw it like early in the video. Taylor, she was playing. I don't know what the name of this game was, but it was like she was having fun. She was really, really into it. She was intense. She was really focusing. I had enough room to record the second time she played, but excuse me. But it was a draw. She played another guy. It was a really good game. I don't know what it's called, but I may try it next year. But I also want to get a good shout out to my boy Victor Quick One. You know, he definitely looked out for us, man. Make sure you check him out on YouTube as well. Just burp, excuse me. But with him, man, like he really looked out for us this year. He got us a hotel in the Motor City Casino. And we also had an Airbnb, and I'm gonna have to say the Airbnb and breakfast to me was a whole lot better than the Motor City Casino. I'm just saying. I said, why you think it's white? True. Why you think of that? Because, man, I don't know. It's like it was a nice view at the Motor City Casino, but I think we just had a better view of like the whole layout of the city in Detroit when we was at the Airbnb. God almighty, that was good. So, like, for me, like, so Friday was supposed to be the official first day for Youmacon, because we had to pick up Taylor's ticket, or her badge. But what ended up happening was, Vic had to do some running around. So I'm like, dog, Vic, okay, man, so, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. So the plan was, we go to Kobo, chill at Kobo for a little bit, get her badge. No, I'm sorry, we go check in, get our badge, and get like a cab back to the Airbnb. That was the plan. What ended up happening was, we checked into the B&B. I'm still in my Captain America outfit, we put a check into the we checked to the B&B and we just stayed there. I was like, for some odd reason, I think we just all got forgot and we got tired. Taylor didn't remind us, so we were just in there just chilling, having a good old time with that. And you know, we played a couple of games. I actually watched the Crown Jewel in our room. Very disappointed that I might do a reaction to the Crown Jewel. I don't know if I am or not. Still debating on that. So our official first day was Saturday. And as usually on Youmacon, it's bumping, everything's going, I don't know, everything's doing good, whatnot. I did a group photo for my Deku. Why I keep getting Midoriya. I'm gonna say Midoriya for crying out loud. I can't get the day right. I did a couple of group pictures because I was actually by myself. I caught up my homeboy, Zoe, those of you know as Charles on Facebook and Instagram. I would ask him to some of those pictures for me, but he was doing like a whole big Marvel shoot, so he couldn't help me with my shoot. So that was cool. I'm eventually going to sit down on Youmacon page and see what's up. Hopefully, I like doing this rope. I like, Jesus, Terrence, can you talk? God. But I like doing the group photos. I think those are actually fun to do. So first day, I think the only person I got a chance to run into, I want to say, was actually Team Four Star. Man, what can I say? Meeting those guys for the second time was a blast. Like I said, I got the pictures to prove it. If you don't believe, if you don't want to wait for the pictures in this video, go to my Facebook, Terrence King Game Woods. Look up some of my Youmacon pictures, because my goal was today, usually I had to get shout outs when I go to these events, but it wasn't the case this time, because what I really want to do, next to Alonzo versus Charles, what I wanted to do this time around, I just want to really mingle. And just take pictures and get to know people, talk to them, because that's eventually what I did. Got a guy who signed up to my Twitch page and our group channel, which I was really excited about. I really thank the guy for that. I wish I could remember the lady's name. I don't got my bag down here. I might, if I can remember her name. Matter of fact, hold on. I'm looking in the book. There she at. That's the autograph side. I don't want to see that. Give me a second. Okay, here it is. Samantha Inoue Hardy. Now, she is, she has a part in the live action version of Battle Angel Alita. And meeting her, oh my God, she's a very talkative person, but she's funny talkative. Sorry, that's my phone going off. That's like the second time I looked at it. And talking to her, because I was trying to meet Wendy Lee. I was trying to meet Wendy Lee on Saturday. And I was like, she was just so funny, bro. And she signed an autograph, so I told her that I grew up watching Battle Angel Alita. I was like, she's like, you watched it? Yeah. I said, I watched that. That's one of the things, like, I grew up watching. That's one of the things, one of the many shows I watched that kept me going anime for a long time. And so what she told me was very hilarious. Man, I'm gonna show you her picture. Her right there. Samantha Inoue Hardy. She said she got the whole cast and crew to sit there, watch the show, so they get like a better understanding of the character and everything like that. We need more people like her to do that, because shows like Full Metal Alchemist, Death Note, Attack on Titan, those live action movies was awful. I don't mind them telling their own stories, but you gotta do it right. Like how did Bleach do it, they did it so nice and cool. They set the one story arc and they ran with it. That's all I'm saying. One star ran with it, and now more likely they're gonna get a sequel. You heard it here, folks. I did a reaction to that movie as well. Love it. You guys should go see it. But I met like about 3 or 4 celebrities this year. I think the only problem that I really couldn't meet, like, I wanted to meet John St. John. I couldn't go around to meeting him because time would always be an issue and a factor when you're trying to meet celebrities and stuff like that. So that was the thing. And I got a chance to meet Wendy Lee. I'm going to show you guys something. Hold on. This is something she signed for me. Okay. Do you guys ever heard... Have you guys ever heard of this anime movie? You haven't? Shame on you. Shame. It's called Perfect Blue. It's one of the animes I grew up watching a long, long time ago. And, so when I found out Wendy Lee was supposed to be here, I was ecstatic because she signed it. And I believe this is Rumi on the cover. That's what the cover on. I wanted to sign. Yeah, I think this is Rumi. That's why I wanted to sign this one. And it says Wendy Lee, Rumi. So I forgot definitely sign. That's one of the main antagonists in Perfect Blue. The funny thing is, I expected a lot of Yoruichis, a lot of Faye Valentines at Youmacon. So the funny thing was about that, I saw like maybe 3 Yoruichis and like maybe 1 Faye Valentine, which I was very shocked about. So, and I knew, and I didn't know she played the voice of Bulma for Dragon Ball Super, which was also amazing. So what I did, I was debating either buying this or buying like a Yoruichi poster or a Bulma poster, or if I can have one poster with all 3 of them together or something like that. I was like, you know what? And so, like, basically what was going on, the posters and stuff I was ordering wasn't going to get here in time for Youmacon. So what I had to do was maybe just go ahead and buy the DVD, the Blu-ray version, and so hope, pray to God that it get here on time. And it did. It got, like I said, that's how I was able to get it signed. So the reason I'm bringing this up, because I was the only one, I want you guys to hear me, I was the only one to get this to her. And she said, like, you are the only person that had me to sign this. And it was like during their, it was the anniversary of Perfect Blue anyway, so I was kind of excited about that. That's a little notch on my belt. And so also during that time, I got a chance to talk to Wendy, I got a chance to talk to Carrie Ann Savage. Those of you don't know who Carrie Ann Savage is, but I didn't mean to refresh the memory. This, guys, if you haven't heard of this anime, is Kenichi, the Mightiest Disciple. I've been watching this junk from Jump. Basically one of my favorite animes to watch. I never actually finished it. That's why I bought the whole DVD set, which is these two right here, which is volume one, volume two. Yeah, are they both volume one? They're both volume one. Oh, one part two. Okay. So it's one part one, part two. Okay. And no, there she is. She signed that for me. And, the funny thing about it's something about meeting these voice actors, and knowing they're just like us, and it's awesome. So it was really, really cool to meet Carrie. So the first time I met Carrie, I took a picture where I talked to her. Let her know that I actually had my Battle Vince's manga behind me, but. I wanted her to sign that, but I was like, I don't know which one her to sign. So I was like, Bumper, give me the DVD. And I told her I was watching some of her work, and she was like, I told her, like, you said, you're like one of the ones that kept me watching anime for like a good while, and like, so I wanted to take a picture with her. You're gonna see it towards the end of this video. I took a picture with her, and I was surprised to the picture. I was like, I would love to take a picture with you, but if you don't got time, I'll do it for the photo op. So the photo op was like at 2:00 Sunday. So she's like, no, we got time to take a picture. I'm like, cool. I was like, all right. So I took a picture with Carrie and Mom. So I took a picture of her. She's like a very nice person. And there's a part two to the story I'm going to get to in a minute because I skipped something. So, like I said before, I met Team Four Star Gang. Me and them guys were great. What I wanted to do, and I asked Lanny Pator, you know, he's one of the lead, like, directors and producers and writers for team for the Dragon Ball Z Abridged. And I showed them a picture from 2015, and I told them, I was like, yeah, I still had a picture from you right then. So I asked them, I was like, what was So when you did, I saw an old video of your voice act. We did some of your voice acting stuff. So like, did you just do it? Did you took classes? Like, what did you do? You said you just did it. Cause like, my goal mainly for next year is at least do some voice acting stuff. Not just, no, I just want to do it for my channel. Cause I want to do some animation stuff for my channel as well. I want to do a whole bunch of stuff differently. Just more. Just playing video games, and I don't have a problem doing video games because that's what most of my channel is. But I want to add more to that. So, meeting them, they was God. Like then I got a picture with all of them. That was amazing, and talking to them was really cool, especially Tahata 101 because I remember he did a shot for my video at that time with T-Bone Soul. So he wasn't dub T-Bone Soul 421. I'm like, bro. I was like, whatever, I'll keep it. I'm gonna keep this blooper. But I bought this shirt for them. You see, I already wore it once. It's called Piccolo Shia Island shirt. So I'm like, if you guys really see it that good, I'm sure you can. Yeah, zoom up and down. I gotta have this shirt. It's like, this was cool. It was amazing. And those of you know, I went to Motor City Comic Con earlier this year, and I got my Goku gi. The top, right? I got my full Goku. Oh, got my shield. Okay, so hold on. Got my shield. Hold on, guys. So, I got my top part of my Goku gi. So, when I went to Motor City. And, okay, my chair. My butt. Okay. So, what I asked, can everyone, everybody on Team 4 Star to sign this? And they did. And I was like, yo, I said, once get a little straightened up over here, I'm going to laminate this and have it on my wall. And I hope to do a future video on that for you guys. So again, it's like I really want, and by talking to him, it encouraged me. And like, cause like I said, they're just like us, but they get paid more and they get paid what they do. So second day rolls around. So I got to meet Matt Middleman. Now, those of you don't know who Matt Middleman is, he's he does the voice of Saitama in One Punch Man. I also didn't know he played the voice of King. So I asked him to sign my Captain America shield. I'm gonna get it a little closer to you guys so you can see it. Yes, this is. That's my sword figure too. Jesus. Yes, I asked him to sign that. Took a couple of pictures with him. He was cool. And I also bought this shirt right here, guys. Nah. You should already know why I bought this shirt for. I bought it for Resident Evil 2. I am not wearing this shirt until Resident Evil 2 remake comes out. Pin that shirt on for the so that's one of the new Let's Plays I'm going to do for next year. When I get done with Street Fighter, when I get on Street Fighter 5, that's the next Let's Play I'm doing. Bam. So, part two of meeting Carrie Ann Savage. Man, let me tell you. So. She's already signing autographs. I already got an autograph from her. So you know, I want to get a photo out with her. So what I did was I was like, you gotta take card. That's like no. So I had to truck it all the way to these ATM machines. I'm like, I gotta get it. So about two ATM machines was out of money, and I couldn't. I'm like, oh my bro. I was like, God, he ain't got no money in these things. So I finally found one. I'm like, I'm gonna walk back because wearing this. All day, it's hot, it's sweating, you losing weight, more than likely. This is hot leather. So I was like, oh God, it's a 150. I was like, 155. I was like, So I ran back, got a picture with her. And I was the only one, but it's a blessing. I'm gonna tell you why it's a blessing for me. Because having a one-on-one talk with her was so good. And the thing is, she remembered me. It's only yesterday, but still. And I told her, like, yeah, just said I was sitting there talking to the photography, waiting for Carrie to get in. And it was like, so yeah, this guy ran from ATM, it's from ATM to ATM just to come meet you. I was like, she ain't lying. I'm trying to wipe the sweat off. It's like, she ain't lying, you know, whoo, doing this the whole time. So, meeting her and having a chance to really talk to her was like cool. Like it's like when I talk about I did do a reaction to Youmacon last year. Okay. When I talked to Kyle Herbert, last year when I talked to him and asked him. He's like, you know, I said, no, I told him, I was like, say thank you for doing what you're doing. He said, thank you for being a fan. I'm like, man, you just put the heartstrings right now, bro. It's like, come on, dog. Come on, man. You can't be doing that to me. But when I was talking to Carrie and I was just telling her that how much I appreciate her work. You know, I said, thank you for doing what you've been doing. And I'm just honored to meet you. And I meant every word of that. I said, it was just a privilege just to meet you, just to sit down and talk, chat with you. And thank you for keeping me anime. And she was like, she said, I'm about to cry. I said, don't make me cry, I'm about to cry. I told my brothers that. I said, man, stop being a wolf. I said, man, stop crying. I was like, man, this childhood, keep me in there. So so I took a picture with her. And I know probably everybody done found her social media stuff, but when she sat there and told me, say, find me on Twitter and Facebook, and so you gotta stay in contact. And then she told me these different shows that she was working on. I can't remember the ones, but I actually seen some of the character previews. And man, it's just like meeting her was just like something about me to me. Like, people say you shouldn't meet your childhood idols. They're wrong. They 100% wrong. Okay, all right. My grandmother's calling me, guys. I love you guys so much. And again, Youmacon was great. I love Youmacon. Get ready to watch these videos right quick. Love you. Deuces. And y'all have a nice day. Okay, I just want to say one more thing. Meeting celebrities, especially Carrie Ann Savage, it hit a spot. It really hit me, guys. I'm just so serious. Meeting her was cool, and I hope one day she responds to my messages. But no, again, that's not a stalker person. No, I asked her how she got into voice acting, and I thank her, and I just thank her for me, just thank her for me and her. So that's all. And about this too. All right, that's it. I'm done. Watch the last part. Watch the video. Watch the pictures. Love you guys. Deuces. I'll see y'all in the next one.
Shadows holding on. Yeah. for you.